Hi, there can be. AI here, AI there, AI everywhere. Not sure if you heard about all the news about AI, but you cannot run away from it, me either. And it brought some anxiety for many people, including me. So last weekend, I decided that's enough. I'm going to sit down and work it out, work out the relationship of myself, my work, my life with AI, and what's the strategy I'm going to deal with it. So here's the outcome that I got. I know the core of my value of my work and life is not about AI, but about something else. And also I know the percentage. So it's just a couple of minutes that you can do something similar for your work and life. Let's see how did I do it. Cool, now we are in Notion and let's see how it works. I've already got the activities written down, and here it's just something that I do every day in a work day. For example, wake up in the morning, check my Twitter, and work out and make breakfast, things like that. So from the moment I wake up till the time I go to bed, I just copy and paste it here for the use. And also here I already write down the prompt, and let's see, I got two. The first one is to tidy the text into a table. First column is time, starting from 6 a.m. and end at 11. Second column is activity. So let's just copy it and select the text, and then we ask AI to do the job. Key in the prompt, and then we will have this table, and let's insert it below. And now we got a table with the time starting from 6. That's what I did. And yeah, it's not totally accurate, can be adjusted. For example, I can cut it off from here to 7:20 or like 8:10, things like that. So you can adjust those time to make it match your real activity of a day. And then after that, I just select the second prompt, add a column at the end of the table to calculate the duration of each activity. So I copy it and select the table, and again there's ask AI. We just tap it, click it, and then paste the prompt and press enter. Now we got another table with those duration at the end of those activities. Just insert below. And from here you can probably calculate something. For example, for me, those are the things will be not relevant with AI. This could be, so I just highlight this because, you know, checking Twitter, this is something relevant to technology, and those are not. And during my own project, I mean writing, making podcast, things like that, that could be involved with AI. And working, okay, definitely be involved with AI. I just highlight it, and then here continue to work. By the way, those numbers are not accurate, so I work longer than just 3 hours in the afternoon. Okay, and later making dinner, draw, and play guitar or other games. And then here, probably this one could be relevant with AI. And then read books, wash up, and go to bed. Right, from here I can probably know that I got half an hour, 1 hour, and 2.5 hours, which means that 4 hours in sum, and 3 hours, 7 hours, and eight, and 1 hour, eight. So now I've got 8 hours could be with AI. Okay, and now we have 24 hours per day, right? So which means that if I calculate it, 8, which means that 33% of my daily time will be involved with AI. And this is how I calculate it. And here is another option. I also listed here. Another option is we have the same activities, but the prompt is different. And this time I just use this prompt to help me do some ideation work. I asked it first the same. Just tidy the text into a table. First column is time, and then second column is activity. And then third column is AI. Fill the role with a short description of how AI can help me to support those activities. And fourth column is examples. So just give me one example. Let's see how it works. I will just copy it at the end of this document. And then I will copy the prompt, select the text, key in the prompt. Let's see how it works. Awesome. You see something's different on this table. And let's just insert below. You can see I have the same thing, time, activity, but then we have AI. And here are just some examples or some possible scenario that I might use. For example, social media monitor and an AI tool that alerts you to important tweets or trending topics. I probably don't need that. I probably need an AI tool to alert me not doing that, right? And workout fitness tracking app, AI, a smartwatch that tracks your heart rate and calories burned. That could be work, and this is what I'm currently doing. Okay, making breakfast. This is something I think is not relevant to AI, but still, we can see the recommendation. Okay, recipe recommendation, AI. Okay, an app can suggest recipe based on my dietary preference or what ingredient that I have on hand. That could be interesting, right? I'm not going to details, but even play guitar or games, music or gaming AI, and AI can generate music or games based on your preference. That's so cool. Right, now you see this is the how I did it. And then after this work, this analyze, I got this number, which is really important. I know 33% of my time could be involved with AI. Right, as a wrapping up, starting with the simplest thing, I get out all the activities of my workday, analyze it, and then I know the results. Around 30% of my daily time will be involved with AI, or could be involved with AI. And that's actually a quite high percentage, 30% of my whole day time. And if my job is a construction worker, a chef, or other hospitality jobs, that might not that high, but my work and my interest is all about technology, so that could be quite high. And also it is a really good reminder or a baseline for me to understand that 70% still the larger percent of my life is not about AI or technology. It's about my work, my daughter, my family, the food I eat, the music I hear, and the entertainment and the activity and workout and other things that I do without technology, without AI being involved. So that's also remind me, focus on those things really valuable for me. And the third thing that I find this activity is valuable is that I know that could be some potential improvement of those 30% that I can try to do to increase more value, to add more value of my time, and so that I can work less, create more, and spend more time with my family and the things I love. Hope that's interesting. And if you want to get more videos and tips about tech, productivity, design, AI stuff, stay tuned, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.